In this video, I'll show you the correct way to use the new OpenAI o3-Mini model in n8n. And yes, we will not be using services like OpenRouter, which will ensure we get the best possible performance at the lowest possible cost. Well, this was not on my bingo cards for this week at all. OpenAI just released a new reasoning model, and I must admit, I'm all for it. DeepSeek Labs blew everyone away this week with the release of their open source R1 model, and it's definitely an important step forward in training reasoning models with limited hardware and at a lower cost. However, R1 had some serious limitations for those of us who want to build production-grade AI applications, such as the lack of output parsing and tool calling. Not to mention, their website has been unavailable all week, making it impossible to obtain API keys. OpenAI's o3-Mini model addresses all of these issues and includes structured output parsing as well as function calling. What I'm really impressed by is the low latency compared to other models like the o1 model from OpenAI, especially since the o3 model is comparable to the o1 model on some of these benchmarks like math, PhD level science questions, competition coding, and software engineering. So this is the perfect model to throw some very complex problems at. So let's have a look at how we can use this model in n8n. So to get started, I'm going to add a simple chat message node, and this node will trigger an AI agent node. We'll just leave all of these defaults, and now we can go ahead and add our chat model. And let's add the OpenAI chat model node. Then simply select your OpenAI credentials. I'm sure that most of you are familiar with this process, but if you're not, simply go to platform.openai.com/API keys. Then create a new API key, copy the key, and back in n8n, create a new credential, give your credential a name, and paste in your API key. Now, if we click on this dropdown, you might not see the o3-Mini model in this list of available models. And this will most likely be different by the time you watch this video, but if you don't see it in the list, all you have to do is change from list to by ID and then simply manually type in the model name, which is o3-Mini. And that's all we have to do. Let's go back to the canvas. I'm actually going to rename this node to OpenAI o3-Mini. Let's test this out by running the chat. And let's simply say hello. And if you get a response back, it means everything was set up correctly and we are now interacting with o3-Mini. And of course, we can confirm this in the usage page within OpenAI if we go to activities. And here we can see that the o3-Mini model is indeed being used. So from here, we can see it took slightly less than 2 seconds to get the response back. And that is just because these reasoning models are slightly slower because they kind of reason and think through the process before simply outputting a response. All right. o3-Mini also supports function calling, which means we can assign tools to this model. So I'm going to add a web search tool. So under tools, let's go to SERP API. I'll select my SERP API credentials. And if you're unfamiliar with SERP API, this simply allows our agents to perform a Google search. So you can go to serpapi.com, sign into your account, grab your API key, and then simply add your credential to n8n. Let's go back to the canvas. And in the agent, let's assign a system prompt. I'll change this to expression. I'm going to expand this view. Assist the user in finding a movie that meets their requirements. Find exactly one movie. And very important, always use the web search tool to look up information about the movie, like the director, the cast members, the year of release, and the movie runtime. So let's go back to the canvas. Let's go to chat. And let's say, I'm planning a movie night with my friends. We're looking for a horror movie that's under 2 hours long. We can see the agent is calling the SERP API tool, and it's giving us the movie recommendation of The Conjuring, which is directed by James Wan. It also gives us the main cast members and the year it was released. And of course, the runtime. And this is something the DeepSeek R1 model just can't do, as it doesn't allow for function calling. There's another thing the DeepSeek R1 model can't do, and that is to provide structured output. So let's say instead of receiving this information as text, we actually want a JSON object. So to do that, we can go to our agent, we can say require specific output format. Then we can attach an output parser, like the structured output parser. And I'm going to change the schema type to define below. I'm going to expand this. And let's say we want to receive the director name, which is of type string. Instead of cities, we do want to receive the list of cast members. So yes, this needs to be of type array, which is a list of values, and each name will be of type string. Then let's also add a new property called year, and for the year, we'll set a type of string, and below year, we'll create a new property called runtime, and for runtime, we'll set the type as string as well. And I do want to mention, you can also add a description property to each of these. And within description, you can describe what this field is about, like the runtime in minutes, as an example. And this will tell the AI model how to extract this information and in what format it should be returned. Right, I think that's all we need. We've got the director, we've got the cast, we've got the year and the runtime. So let's go back to the canvas. Let's run this exact same query again. So I'm actually going to clear the chat. Let's run this. Right, so it's calling the SERP API tool, it's thinking, and finally it called the structured output parser. So looking at the response, we can see we get this JSON object with the director, with the cast members as an array of values, the year, and the runtime in minutes. Of course, we can also double click on the structured output parser, and here we can indeed see that this is a JSON object and not a string value. So let me know in the comments what you think about this new o3-Mini model and how it compares to DeepSeek R1 in your opinion. If you would like to see how you can set up DeepSeek R1 in n8n, then check out this other video over here. Otherwise, I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.